Hello students, welcome to Prayashu Eju YouTube channel. This is Scholarship Exam Standard 5th online class. So this is a paper 1's mathematics subjects mock question paper test number 1. So in this video we are going to see the answers, or we can say the key answers, and the main whichever the questions are important, so that questions answers I will give the some explanation, but students has to do the multiplication, addition, subtractions and the divisions at your end. Okay, I will just mention the their way of the answer finding and the correct answers. Okay, so summarizedly we will go through the, all these questions. So question number 26, now C plus L after the bracket division by the X, means these are the Roman numbers. Now C means what? C means the 100. Okay, then plus L means that is a 50, I will mention here better way. So here the 50, and after this one division by the 10. So this is a 150 division by 10, means that is a 15. 15 is given in Roman number, means X and V, means option number 3 is the correct one. Now for question number 27, multiplication of these two numbers, what you have to do. So for this the correct answer is option number 4. Then question number 24, which of the following fraction is greater than the 2? So greater than the 2 means quotient is more than the 2, that is the meaning. Okay, means the denominator and the numerator, in this one the denominator should be half of the numerator, or we can say the numerator is 2 times, or we can say more than the 2 times of the denominator. I am again repeating, the numerator should be more than the 2 times of the denominator, then we can get the more than the 2 in a quotient. Okay, so here 9 twos are 18, so this is a 17, means smaller, so this should not be. Here 10 twos are 20, but here 19, so this is smaller. Then here 6 twos are 12, yes, it can be possible, and here 6 to the 12, so this is 11, so this is smallest, means option number 3 is the correct one. 6 to the 12, and here the mention 13, means this is more than the 2. Okay, so option number 3 is the correct one. Then question number 29, a train started at 4 hours 20 minutes in the afternoon, so means we can say 4 and 20 p.m. its destination next day at 11 hour and 40 minutes before the noon. Before the noon, that is the 11 and 40 a.m. Okay, so what is the time taken by the train for the journey? So now this is a p.m. and this is next day. Okay, so this is the first day. Okay, and this is the next day. Now from this, means from the evening to the midnight, means that is, we can say that is the 12 p.m. okay, so that time we will find out. So for this one, 12:00 minus this 4 and 20, so means here the 0 and 20 cannot, so here 11 and then 1 hour we will convert here, an addition with a minute, so 60 minus 20, so that is a 40, and 11 minus 4, that is a 7, so 7 hour and 40 minutes. Then after this midnight to the next day, means in the morning 11, so this is the same timing, so we will add this directly, this timing, because this is the from the 0 to 11:40. okay, so this we will add it, so 0:00 and this 80, so means here the 2 and 6 we will add here. Okay, so means 1 in hour. Okay, so 7 plus this 2, so 9 and this 1, so means 9 hours and 20 minutes. So 9 hours and 20 minutes means option number 1 is the correct one. Then question number 30, a shopkeeper purchased 500 pens for ₹2000. He sold 300 pens at ₹10 each and remaining pens at ₹5. Find the profit. So here, so 300 pens with ₹10 each, so this is the ₹3000, and 5 rupees per pen of remaining, means now 500 minus 300, so that is a 200, and 200 multiplied by 5, so that is a 1000, so that is a, he sell complete all the pens in ₹4000, but purchase in a 2000, so minus this purchase price, so that is a 4000 minus 2000, means that is a 2000, so he make the profit of the ₹2000, which is given in option number 1. Then question number 31, in how many years will the interest on On means this is the principal amount. So we know the principal amount multiplied by rate of the interest multiplied by number of the year. So that is the interest. B, this 5,400 means this is the interest. So this 5,400 is equals to principal amount is 45,000 multiplied by this. PCPA is given, means rate of the interest is 6 multiplied by year. We have to find out, means that is n divided by 100. Now this 20 get cancelled, this 20 get cancelled. So 5400 then divided by this will be in a division. So this 450 multiplied by this 6 is equals to n. Now this 0 get cancelled, this 0 get cancelled. So now 6 ones and 6 nines are 54 and then 0. So 45 ones and this 45 twos are. So n is equals to 2 years, and 2 years is given in option number 4. Now question number 32, how many acute angles are there in this figure? Now acute angles means less than the 90 degree. Now this means SRQ is mentioning this symbol, means this is right angle symbol. So this small angle is acute angle. So this is a 1, okay. Then this will be the 2, because this is the after 90 degree minus something. So this will be also acute angle. So this is 2. Then this is a 3, 4. This one is a 5, 6, and additions of 5 and 6. So that is a 7. So there are the total 7 acute angles. So 7 means option number 2 is the correct one. Question number 33. How is 7 up just 7,770 written in figure? So for this one, option number 2 is the correct one. Then question number 34. 42,500 chocolates. 42,500 chocolates distributed among 2,720 students so that each one get 15 chocolates. Fine. How many chocolates are left? So first of all, we will find out the how many chocolates are distributed in a student. So number of the student multiply by the number of chocolates to each student. So this is 2,720 multiply by 15. So this is getting 40,800. So this is the distributed chocolate, and total is this one. So from this one, we will deduct this. So we will get the option number 2 means 1,700. So option number 2 is the correct one. Then question number 35. What part of the field remained if sugar cane were planted in 7/30 part and vegetable in 3/5 part? Okay, so what part of the field remained? Now field is completely 1. Okay, so mean that is 100%. So we will assume that is the 1. Okay, so from the 1 complete part, sugar cane is this part, okay, and vegetable is this part. So we will add these two and subtract it from this one. So means 1 minus this 7/30 plus this 3/5. Okay, so 1 minus, we will make the here the denominator also the 30. So 7 plus, so here multiplication with the 6 we have to do. So here the 18/30. Okay, so now 1 minus this 7 plus 18, so that is a 25/30. Okay, so here again we will make the denominator same here. So 30 minus 25/30, so that is a 5/30. So means 1/6. So 1/6 part is given in option number 3. Now question number 36. If 25th May is Monday, then which day would be on the coming Independence Day? So I will write here. So in a May month, 25 is mentioned. So 31 minus 25, how many days are remaining in May month? So that is a 6. Then in a June, complete means that is a 30 days. Then July, complete means that is a 31 days. And in August, up to the Independence Day means that is a 15th of August, means 15 days. So we will do the additions of this one. We will get the 82. So 82. So if we divide it by 7 weekdays to the 82, we will get the 5 weekdays as a remaining. Okay, as a remaining. So from this Monday, we have to count the 5 days. So if you count from the Monday, next 5 days means that is a Saturday. So means option number 1 is the correct one. Now question number 37. How many percent is 3.5? So how many percent, suppose this is a blank, how many this percent is equals to 3.5. That is the meaning. So percentage symbol means this multiply by 1 by 100. Already we have learned this one. This symbol means having this value, okay, in the way. So this is a is equal to 3.5. Now this is in multiplication. So means this 100 is here in division to the 1. So we will transfer through this side and it will be multiple to directly 3.5. So 3.5 multiply by with this 100. So this is a 350. So 350 means option number 2 is the correct one. Then question number 38. From the information given in a figure, find the perimeter of the figure. So now, so from the B to C and A to B, so this symbol is showing all these sides are same, means this is also the 12, this is also the 12. Now this symbol is mentioning all these lines are the same. Now this is vertical because of this 90 degrees. So this 1, 2 and 3 parts made from this 12 side, means this is a 4, this one also 4 and this one also 4, and this is also equal. So this is also the 4 and this is also the 4. So 1 2 3 4 and 5, so 5 4s are, that is the 20, plus 12 3s are, so that is the 36. So means 56 centimeter is the perimeter. So this is given in option number 3. Now question number 39, which number will be in the middle if the number, so these are the number arranged in descending. So for the descending means bigger one should be in first. So all are the 6 digit number. So this is a 1, means first one, then after this one the second. So all having the starting with the 32, 32 and here also 32. After the 32 here the 4, here 4, and after this one the 9. So this is a second, okay. And after this one, this is at the third number, means this one will be the middle one. So this is given in option number 4. Now question number 40, how many travelers travel during the month of May if 15,784 travel by bus, now 24,085 by train and 8,476 by car. So total we have to find out. So this number and this number, we have to make the additions. So after this making the additions, you will get option number 3 is a correct one, means 48,345. Then question number 41, if 60 multiplied by this box by 5 is equals to 36, then what number should be in this box? So this 5 1s and 5 12, okay. So 12 multiply by this box means 12 multiply by 3, we are getting 36. So means 3 should be here, and 3 is given in option number 3. Question number 42, while changing rupees 2000 note, the shopkeeper gave 4 note of 200 and equal note of notes 100 and rupees 50, find the total of the note. Okay, so 4 notes of 200 and 4 notes of the 100 also, okay. So means we can say 4 multiply by 300 plus, sorry, 200 plus 100, so that is a 300, okay. We will make the combination because number of the notes also the same, plus this 50 notes we don't know, so 50x, okay, is equals to how much the total? 2000, because changing for the rupees 2000. So now this is a 1200, so 50x is equals to 2000 minus this 1200. I'm directly making the step, next step, because this is here the addition, it will goes here and it will subtract. So 50x is equals to, this is 800, so x is equals to 800 by 50, 0 get cancelled, 0, so this is 16. So x is equals to 16, means there is a 16 notes of the rupees 50, okay. So 16 means option number 4 is the correct one. Then question number 43, 600 notebooks bought at rupees 900 per 100 was sold. Now this rupees 900 per 100 means that is a 100 notebooks for rupees 9 in rupees 900, that is the meaning, okay. Means one notebook having the rupees 900 divided by 100 means that is the rupees 9. So one notebook having the cost rupees 9. Now was sold at rupees 150 per dozen. 150 per dozen. Now, 1 dozen means that is a 12. So, divided by 12. So, this is a 1 and this is a 2. Then, point and 50. So, this is rupees 12 and 50 paise or 12.5. That is the meaning. So, what is the profit or loss in this transition? So, now, in this transition, there is a profit. How much? So, 12.5 minus 9 also we can do. So, this is equals to the 3.5 and multiply by this 600. So, this 20 as it is. So, 6.5 is 30. So, 3 carries. So, 6, 3 is 18 plus 3. So, that is a 21. And this 1 decimal here. So, means 2100 is a profit. Okay. Because he has purchased in this one and he has sold this one. So, this is a profit. So, option number 3 is the correct one. Then question number 44, how many chords are there in the given circle with center O? So chord, how many chords are there but with the center O? So this is the one chord, okay, this is another chord, this is another chord. So 1, 2, 3 and here the and this PT also one chord, okay. So there are the four chords. So four chord means option number 4 is the correct one. Then question number 45, what is total expenses incurred for painting if the cost of the paint is rupees 12,500? Means that is the meaning that 12,500, that is the meaning, and rupees quarter to 9,000. Quarter to 9,000 means 9,000 and minus 250, because quarter is a 250, so that is a 8,750. So then this is the for the labor charge. Then so where to find out the total expenses? So this amount is for the labor charges and this amount for the cost of the paint. So we will make the additions of these two. So after this addition you will get 21,250. Okay, so means in option 21, so in this one the option number one means a quarter and means that is the addition. So quarter means that is a 250 and 21,000. So now here 21,000 we will make the separate and 250 also we will make separate. So addition of these two we are getting this number. So means we can say a quarter and 21,000. So that is the meaning. So option number one is the correct one. Then question number 46, what is the yearly income of Sampatra if his monthly salary is rupees 28,250. So now yearly means how many months in a year? So there are the 12 months. So in one month this is the salary, so we have to multiply by 12. So after this one you will get the option number 4, means this is the amount for the yearly. So option number 4 is the correctly. We have to do the multiplication here. Question number 47, in which of the following number is the place value of digit underline shown correctly? So here option number 2 is the correct one, because here this is the 100th at the place and here the 2/100 is correctly mentioned. So option number 1 is the correct one. Now question number 48, half a liter of milk was bought daily from Gandhi Jayanti. Gandhi Jayanti means 2nd of the October. From this, so this is starting date of the purchasing till the Christmas. Now Christmas is on the 25th of the December. If the rate of milk was rupees 36 per liter, what was the expenses on milk? So here first of all daily half liter, okay, so that is we have to consider, means that is a 0.5 liter, that is mentioned. Now number of the days means starting from the 2nd October, means in October 31 minus 1 we have to do, because 2nd October already purchased. So there are the total 30 days. Now after the October there is the November, so November having the 30 days and in a December that is a 25 days. So this is a 85 days total milk has purchased. Now 85 multiply by 0.5, so that is a we are getting 42.5, this much the liter, and 1 liter having the cost rupees 36, so multiply by 36. So after this multiplication you will get 1530. So this is given in option number 3. Then question number 49, in which of the following alternative did Pratibha write 12 and quarter meter correctly? Now this and means that is addition. Now 12 meter means that is a 12 meter plus quarter meter. Quarter meter means that is a 0.25 meters. So means 12.25 meter, that is the meaning. So this is correctly mentioned in option number 3. Now question number 50. A car was bought for rupees 3.5 lakh. 3.5 lakh means that is a 3 and this half, then lakh means this is 50,000. Okay, so, and 40,000 was spent. 40,000 means additions of this one, that is the expenses on this one, on some repairing. What is the sale price of this car if it is sold by incurring 30,000 loss? Okay, so first of all we will find out this total. So repairing cost plus this purchase cost, so this is the 3,90,000, and loss is there means we have to deduct this 30,000 so that we can get the selling price. So this is the 3,60,000. So this is given in option number 3. Now question number 51. A perimeter of square shape field is a 100 meter. How many plots each of 25 square meter can be made in the field? Now perimeter is given, so first we will find out the side. So this is a square shape, so as we know perimeter by 4 means that is the side. So 100 by 4 means that is a 25 meter is the side of this plot. Now by this 25 meter area we have to find out, so that is a 25 multiplied by 25, so that is a square meter. So that is a 625 square meter. Now one plot having 25 square meter, so divided by 25 square meter, so 25 and this 25 multiplication, then we are getting 625. So there are the 25 numbers, means that much of the plots can be formed. So 25 in a word format is given. Option number 2 is the correct one. Question number 52. By how much is the sum of 11 numbers from 11 to 20 is less than the sum of odd numbers from 1 to 20? So first of all, 11 numbers from this, so there are the total 5 numbers, so 5 multiply by, because there are the 10 numbers but there is the odd number and the even number are the same equally, so 10 by 2 means that is the 5 numbers, and in this one the middle one is the 16. Okay, so 16 5 that is the 80, so this is the additions of this one. Then odd numbers, so from the 1 to 20, as we know there are the 20 numbers but odd number is in a 50% quantity, means we can say half quantity, means that is a 10 numbers, and there average also the 10, because there is a 1 to 19, the middle number is a 10. Okay, so that is a 10 multiplied by 10, that is a 100. Okay, and the difference we have to find out, because there is a mention is less than the sum of this one. So this is comes 100 and this comes the 80. So how much this less? So that is a by 20. So 20 means option number 1 is the correct one. Now question number 53. Which of the following is a pair of co-prime number? So for this one, option number 2 is the correct one, because they have only one as a common factor. Now here 13 also a common factor. In this one the 7 is a common factor also, and in this one 3 also a common factor, but we require the co-prime number, means only one, and only one is the should be common factor. So option number 2 is the correct one. Then for question number 54, which of the following is an equivalent fractions of the fractions 26 by 4? So here we will do the equivalent reduced fractions. So here 13 and here the 2, after take out the 2 as a common factor, so 13 by 2. Now as per this one, if you find out this 2 6 are 12, 12 plus 1 that is the 13, and by 2, so option number 4 is the correct one. Others cannot be equivalent to this one. Now question number 55. Instead of filling bottles of 250 ml, shopkeeper fills 80 more, this more is very important, 80 more bottles of 200 ml each by the medicine. Find how many liters of medicine was used. Now if he has filled each bottle with a 250 ml, and or we can say another condition with a 200 ml, the number of the bottle is getting increases because here the quantity is getting decreases. So number of quantity is increases because there is a quantity of the medicine is the same. So we can compare on this basis. So we will write down here. So there are the X number of bottles can make if we fill the 250 ml of each bottle. Okay. So there is a total quantity of the medicine here. That is the same if we are filling with a 200 ml of each bottle, and after this one we are getting the number of the 80 bottles than this one. So means X plus 80 we are getting the additions of this number of the bottles we have to fill. Okay, means here also the capacity of the total medicine and here also that is the same. So that's why we are getting making this equal. Now this is a 250x is equals to, after this multiplication, so this is a 200x plus here 200 plus multiply by 80 means 2 8s are, that is a 16, and then 3 zeros means this is a 16,000. Now this 250x minus this, here this is a positive, so that's why here negative. So this 200x is equals to 16,000. So now this, after this subtraction, 50x is equals to 16,000. So x is equals to 16,000 divided by this 50. This zero get cancelled, this zero get cancelled. So this is a 3 za 1 2. So there are the number X means 320 bottles. Okay, so if we fill with a 250 ml of this capacity of the medicine in this one. So but asking about the how many liters, so with this one multiplication with 250, because this X is here. Okay, so after this multiplication you will get 80 liter, or we can say 80,000 ml. Okay, so this 80 liter is given in option number 2. Now question number 56, what should be the selling price of sari to get rupees 1500 profit by selling 40 saris bought for rupees 10,000 and spent rupees 500 for transport? So the total bought price is a 10,500. Okay, and after this one we have to make the profit of the 1500. So we will add this one, so we are getting this 12,000. Now this is the selling price and divided by this 40, because there are the total 40 sarees. So this is the 3 and then 00 means that is the 300 rupees price of each saree for selling price. Okay, so means option number 1 is the correct one. Then question number 57, which of the following nets will not fold into cube? So now here this is the cuboid. Now will not be in a cube. Now this can be formed with a cube, or we can say the cuboid, but this type of the net is cannot be make the cuboid. So that's why option number 2 is a totally different. So option number 2 is a correct one. Now question number 58, so hum bested 35,498 festoons and Satish pasted 296 festoons less than that of the Soham. How many festoons altogether were pasted by the two of them? So we will first find out the Satish pasted festoon, which is a lesser than the Soham's this total pasted festoon. So this is a 35,496 minus 296. So we are getting 35,202. So this is by the Satish. Okay, and this one is by the Soham. Now we have to find out the total festoons pasted by altogether. So this and this, we have to do the additions of this one. So after this addition you will get option number 1 is the correct one, which is 70,700. Now question number 59, if this number minus there is a unknown means box is there is equals to this number, then which number should be in the box? To find out this one, we have to subtract this number from this number. So after this subtraction you will get 219444, means option number 2 is the correct one. So after this subtraction you will get 21,964, means option number 4 will correct. Now question number 60, how is the fraction read. Now this can be read 0.25 means option number 2 is a correct one. Now question number 61, which of the following is the correct alternative for 260 minutes? Now here are the minutes and all the options containing hours and the minutes. So 260 minutes means we have to divide it by 60, so that is a 4, and then after this one the remainder is a 20, means 4 hours and 20 minutes. So this is given in option number 3. Now question number 64, what is the rate of interest if rupees 13,500 is paid to bank at the end of the year to clear the debentures of rupees 12,500, means this is a complete amount including the principal amount and the rate of interest. So first of all we will find out the rate of interest, so that's why 13,500 minus this 12,500, so now after this subtraction we are getting this 1000 as a simple interest. Okay, so as we know the simple interest means SI is equals to PRRN, this is the formula divided by the 100. Now SI already we have seen, which is a 1000, is equals to principal amount is a 12,500 multiplied by end of the year, a year means that is the year is the 1 year. Okay, we have to find out the rate of the interest, so rate of the interest is R as it is multiplied by 1N, means that is the period, so this is a divided by 100, so this 20 get cancelled, this 20 get cancelled. Now 1000 divided by this 125 is equals to this R, this is a 8, so R is equals to 8 PCPA, okay, percent per annum. So R 8 PCPA means option number 4 is the correct. Now question number 63, which of the following is the opposite face of the face QNML of the given figure of the cuboid. Now Q, now this Q is here, N, M and L, so these are the vertices, so this is the figure and this is the face, so opposite of this one means this one, so means JKPO, so JK or POJK, so option number 1 is the correct one. Now question number 64, which of the following numbers is exactly divisible by 2, 3 and 5? So now all the number having 0 at the unit place means that can be divisible by 0 because by 2 means because now all the number can be divisible by 2 because this 0 is an even number. Also all these number can be divisible by 5 because there is a 0 at the unit place as per the divisibility test of 2 and the 5 respectively. Now where to find out only about the 3 now. So the additions of all the digits in a number, so if that is a, in a multiplication of the 3, then that number can be divisible by 3, so that is the rule. So if you count all these additions of this numbers digits number, you will get the option number 4 means 40,980 can be divisible by 3. So if that is divisible by 2, 5 and 3 means this is the exactly divisible which are searching for this question. So option number 4 is the correct one. Now question number 65, 60 notebook each of equal pages are prepared from 11,520 pages. How many pages do each notebook has? So to find out the each notebook having the how many pages as required, so this total number of the pages means 11,520 divided with total number of the notebooks we are making, so which is a 60, so this 0 get cancelled, this 0 get cancelled, so 6 ones are, and here 6 ones are, 5 balance 55, so 6 9s are 54, 1 balance then 12 and 6 2s are, so there is a 192 notebook can be do, so this is a given in option number 2. Then question number 66, how many kilograms is equal to 4500 grams? As we know 1 kg is equals to 1000 gram, so means we have to divide this by the 1000, so means 4.5 kg will be, now 4 0.5, or we can say now here 4.5 means that is a given 4.5 means option number 3 is the correct one. Now question number 67. 2100 consists of some notes of rupees 50 and number of rupees 200 notes are half of rupees 50 notes. If 12 notes are of rupees 100, then find out the total number of the notes. So assume 50 number of the notes are the x. Okay, so as per this means 200 notes are the half of this one, half of the 50 notes, means that is the x by 2. And if 12 notes are of rupees 100 is already given, so and this is the total amount, so we can say 50 number of the notes is x, so multiply with x means 50x plus this 200 and multiplication with x by 2, so 200 then x and then divided by 2, so then additions of this one, 12 notes of the 100, so means 12 multiply by 100 and is equals to 2100. So this is total amount, so 50x plus, now these 2 ones are and these 2 ones are, so this is 100, so 100x plus this is a 1200 and this one is the total. Now this is here addition, so it will go here and it will subtracted from this one, and here the 150x, so now x is equals to this difference is a 900 and this is the division with a 150, so x is equals to 60 notes, so 60 notes of the 50 and here the 60 by 2 means 3 notes of the 200 and here the 12, but asking about total number of the notes means 6 plus 3 that is a 9, 9 plus this 12, so that is a total 20 notes, 21 notes are there, means that is the option number 1 is the correct one. Now question number 68, what is the percentage of marks if 603 marks is scored out of 900 marks in examination? So 603 out of means that 900 should be in denominator, so this denominator should be out of 1. Okay, so after this divisions we are getting, so this 100 we will keep it as it is, so this 603 by 9 multiplied by 1 by 100 as it is, so this 100 from this 900 we are keeping same, so 9 ones are 9, 6 are 54, then 6 balance 63, so 9 7 are 63, so this one is a 67 multiplied by 1 by 100. Now 1 by 100 means that is a percentage and 67 as it means that is a 67%, that is the meaning, so option number 3 is the correct one. Now question number 69, complete the following pattern. Now in this one and in a second pattern you will observe this group is here present, so means completely will goes at the right end. Okay, after this one this completely goes at the right one and this will form, so for the next to replace the question mark, so this two will be goes at the end one, so starting with the triangle, so option number 2 and 3 is there, option number 1 and 4 are incorrectly. After this one the two positive signs, so here also and here also, and then this circle and then square, so this circle and the square, but here square is mentioned, so option number 2 is incorrectly, only option number 3 is the correct one. Then question number 70, what is the difference in the place value and the face value of the digit 7? So digit 7 is here unit, tens, hundreds, thousands and 10,000, means that is a 70,000 minus the face value is the 7, so after this one you will get option number 1 is the correct one after this subtraction. Now question number 71, if 150 plus 50 divided by 5 multiplication of the 10 is equals to 500 minus x, then what is the value of the x? So first we will solve this one, so here division should be first, which is at the left side, so this 50 by 5 means that is a 10 and this 150 as it is plus sign also, and multiplication of this 10. Now we will solve the multiplication, so 10 multiplied by 10, so that is 100 and then this 150 as it is. Now 150 plus 10 100, so that is a 250. Now 250 is equals to this 500 minus x, so now x is equals to 500 minus this 250, so x is equals to 250. So option number 2 means 250 is a correct one. Now question number 72, if denominator of the fraction is 24 by 42 is changed to 21, means denominator has to change, means it has to change from 42 to 21, means we have to divide it by 2 and same has to divide it to the numerator, so by 2, so means in the numerator, so that will be 12, so then the what will be the in the numerator, so that will be 12, and 12 is given in option number 4. Now question number 73, how many paper should be added to 3 gross paper to make 1 rim paper? Now 1 rim paper means that is a 480 papers as we know, and 3 gross, so 1 gross is equals to 12 dozen, so 12 dozens and 1 dozen having the 12 papers, and here are the 3 gross, so multiplication with 3, so this is given, so after this multiplication you will get 432. So to make this 1 rim paper, how many papers we require, so difference should be there, so means 480 minus 432, so if you find out the difference, so you will get 48 papers, so 48 is given in option number 3. Now for question number 74 and the 75, answer the question given below the pictorial information. Now here girls and the saplings planted, so here Aarti is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and one sapling is a 13 sapling, so means that is we can say 6 multiplied by 13 means there are the total 78. Here Varsha is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 multiplied by 13 means that is 65 saplings. Rupa 3, so means that is a 39, and Reshma is a 4, means that is a 4 multiplied by 13, so that is a 52. So now we will solve the question. So question number 74, how many more sapling are planted by Aarti than Reshma? Aarti is planted, we know 78, and Reshma is planted 52, so 78 minus 52, so 78 and here the 52, so this we are getting 26, so 26 means option number 4 is the correct one. Now question number 75, what percent of sapling are planted by Rupa than those planted by Varsha? So by Rupa is 39 and by Varsha 65, so means Rupa 39 sorry and Varsha 65, so how many sapling planted by Rupa? So the difference is here 26, okay, so 26 is the difference, and the total is a 39 plus 65, so that is a 104, so 26 and 104 means there is a difference is the 40%, but asking about the planted by the Rupa means Rupa is if we deduct this from 100 minus 40% means we are getting 60%, means Varsha is planted more 60% than the Rupa, actually here not a than, Rupa should be here and Varsha should be here, write down, so Varsha planted than the Rupa, that is the meaning, so 60% means option number 1 is a correct one. Thank you.